Hi, this is Elaine with Green Path Herbs School, and I wanted to talk to you today about a plant that I really, really love, and it's actually beloved by many people all over the world, and that's rose. So I have just a few little examples here from the garden. Here is just a little rose bud, which I think is just probably the sweetest part of rose. Like, I just love the way the little buds look. I also have a hip here, which is still ripening. So it's not quite ripe. And this is from our wild rose bush right outside the school. And so it's small for a rose hip, but there's lots of different sizes and hips. And then I have these dried petals, and these are from my garden, and I've dried them this year. I just collected, I would go out in the morning time and collect the rose petals in one of my gathering baskets, lay them out on a screen in my garage where it was nice and dark, and let them dry. And so rose makes a lovely tea. Like, you can, and it actually is such a beautiful herb. So I love to put it in a tea mixture, and I really like it for recovery. So for instance, if someone has had surgery or had some kind of a traumatic experience or something like that, I love putting rose petals in tea for them. It's also a wonderful women's herb, so really nice for the reproductive system, great tonic and astringent. And because it's an astringent, and also because of the smell, it's used a lot in skincare and body care products. And so one of my favorite things to do with the petals is to add them to extra virgin olive oil and macerate them, blend them up really well, and let them soak for about a month or so. And then I use that as an oil on my skin. So I can do like a face oil with it, or sometimes I'll add that oil and make a lotion or something like that. And it is absolutely heavenly. Like, the smell is just incredible. So that's probably one of my very favorite ways to use rose. Another thing I love about rose is it is a tonic and strengthener for the heart and the cardiovascular system, and both for the physical heart, but also for the emotional heart. So another really key way that I use rose is for someone who is brokenhearted, has had a heartache or a heartbreak, and I feel that that impacts not just the emotional self, but also the physical heart. And so to take rose for that, I feel like kind of works on these layered levels for the cardiovascular system, including those emotional aspects and that very physical aspect of heart health itself. And one of my favorite ways to use rose like that is to make a tincture, and I usually make that in brandy. And then I will add some flower essences to that, specifically rose flower essence and also rose quartz, and then maybe even a drop of the pure essential oil of rose otto into the tincture. And I'll have someone take one drop of that every day to heal the heart, to heal their emotional heart, and also to open their heart. Right, so if they feel they've been hurt in the past, but they want to be open and receptive, it's a really, really wonderful way to do that. So those are some of my favorite ways to use rose. I'd love to hear how you like to use rose in the comments below. So have a wonderful day. Thank you so much.